हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई अनिल सजनानी वेलकम यू टू माय वीडियो लेक्चर पार्ट टू ऑफ सिंगली लिंक्ड लिस्ट। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट क्रिएटिंग अ लिस्ट ऑफ एनी नंबर ऑफ नोड्स अगेंस्ट द वन विच वी डिस्कस्ड इन द पार्ट वन ओनली फॉर थ्री नोड्स एंड देन वी विल क्रिएट अ लिस्ट विद डिस्प्ले फंक्शन using switch case and break in C compiler. In part 1 of singly linked list, we created a basic list with three known nodes, namely first, second and third, as you know. The nodes are created directly in the pointer variables first, second and third. Here, first we declared variable pointers first, second, third and one extra P of data type node, and then we created three nodes first, second and third. Since we knew the names first, second and third, we easily assigned the values. This is very important to note here that since we know the next node to be attached its name, so we have directly mentioned the pointer to the next node like this. You can see here, after first we have to attach second node, so we said next of the first is second. Similarly, second node is attached with the third and third one is given the value null. The resultant list is like this. In this video, we do not have a finite number of nodes like the previous one, first, second and third. We may have one, we may have 100 or maybe more than that nodes. So the procedure we will follow is like this. Whenever we have to add a node in the list, we will create it under a common name, that is head, which is again a pointer of type node like we have first, second and third. Now here you can see that we have taken a node type variable pointer head, and we have created this head as a node with the value 3 and next of the head is given the value null. Now if this node is the first one in the list, then we should assign the name first to it, and we will add one more name to it, maybe the last or the temp, because if this is the first node in the list, it will be the last one also. So we will give a name first and last to this if this is a first node. That we will assign like this. First is equal to head and last is equal to head. So in this way, head has three names now: head, first and last. Now why we have given two names, first and last? It will be clear in few next slides. Now we have to add another node in this list. By now we have only one element or one node in the list, which is shown here, which has a null entry in the next and some data 3 in the data field. With three names, head, first and last, head is immaterial, we are concerned with first and last. Now to add the second node, create a node with head again and assign the value. So this is what we have from the previous step. Now we have created the node with the value 4, and since we have created this node and we are assuming that the node will be added at the end of the list, so the last node of the list should have a next value null. So we have assigned next of head to null. So now this node is created in the memory, which we need to attach with the first one. Now after running these three statements, we will have a new node like this, which is again having a null entry. The name is head. Now this head is to be attached with this node in the list. So as you know, this will become the last node in that case, and first node's null should have an entry of this node, only then this will be attached with the first one. So how to do this? First we will run the statement next of the last is equal to head. So now you can understand this is the last node at present. Its next is at present null, and to this we are passing the address of the head, so that now this null will be removed and it will be pointing to this head. So in this way the head is attached to the null. This is step number one. Second one, since now this head is connected with the first one, so now this head should become the last node. So what we will do, we will change the name of this head to last. So here you can see the node is attached, the head is attached with the first last at present. Now we will be changing the name of this head to last, so that this will remain the last and we can add more nodes to it. That we will do by running the command last is equal to head. So when we say last is equal to head, so that means now this has become the last. Like this, now we have a list of two nodes, the first one, the last one, and now we will try to add one more node into this. So for that, again we will create a head. You can see here we will create a head here. For the third node we are assigning value 5, and because this is the last node, so we are making it the next of the head as null. As you know, by running this command a head is created like this. Now we have to attach this head in this list. That we will do by giving the address of this node to last. We will say next of last is equal to head. So in that way this head will be connected with the list. So we have run next of last is equal to head, and since this will become the last one, so we are saying last is equal to head, so this will become the last. So after running these two statements, this head will be connected to the list, and this head will be changed to the name last. So in this way we can keep on creating the head, we can keep on adding them, and since we know the last node, so we can always say next of last is equal to the head which is newly created, and then we will change that newly created head as a last by running this command. So this is how we can create a singly linked list. Here we have only one question: how will you know whether the node which you have created is going to be the first one or it is going to attach in the last? What we will do is, when we declare the pointers of the variables type node, at that time we will say first is equal to null. So you can see here, first we will declare the pointers first, head, last and temp of node type with the first is equal to null, as long as first is null, that means we do not have any node. So how to create a function which will create a node in the list by identifying whether my node is a first one or it is to be added at the last of the list. For that we will run following statements. Here you can see, first we are saying, after creating the node, we are saying if first is equal to null, that means there is no node existing, because first is null means there is no node. If there is no node, that means the node which you have created is will going to be the first node. If this is the first node, then in that case you will give the names of this node as first and last. You can see here, if first double equals null, that means no node existing, so your node which you have created will become the first and the last one. If this condition is not true, that means you have already added a node in the first one, so in that case this next of first would have some entry of the last node. So this statement will go false. If this goes false, that means list is already existing, there will be a last node to which you will be attaching this node. So in that case we will say that next of the head is equal to null, because this is going to be the last node, and we will say the next of last, because in that case last is existing. So we will say next of last is equal to head, like previously we have seen. So this will attach this node with the list, and then we will make this node as the last one. So we will say last is equal to head. So this is how we have created a create function which will create a head in the singly linked list. So now we will switch to compiler and we will see its working in the C compiler. Now we are in the compiler. Here we will be using the same program whatever I have explained you earlier. First we have created a structure SList. Since we are using the keyword type def, in spite of using the data type struct SList, now we can use the word node. Now in the structure we have one data field and another one is a pointer to the next node. Now you can see we have taken the variable pointers of the type node globally, so that we can use them in any of the function. We have taken the pointer variables first, which is equal to null, showing the empty list. Then we have head, in which we will create the nodes. The last, which we will take as the name of the last node. And there is one extra pointer if required, that is p. Now in the create function, we have taken an integer variable d, which we will be using to input the data from the user. So now here you can see we have used the head variable for creating the node. After creating the node, now we are passing a message to the user to enter the data field. We will scan the data from the user under the variable d, and then we are assigning this value to the data of the head. Then we are testing, as I explained you, whether it's a first node or it's a node which is going to be attached with the last node. If the list is empty, that means there is no node, and first double equals null is a true condition. So in that case, the node which is created above will be the first node. In that case, as I showed you, that this head will become the first node as well as the last node, which we have defined here under the if statement. But if the first is not equal to null, that means the first has a link of the next node, so we will be attaching this node to the last node. So that means last node is existing. So in that case, the else part will work, where we have shown that the next of the head will be null, because in that case it will be a last node, and since it is a last node, so it will be assigned to the last. As you can see here, head is equal to last. Since now it will become the last node, the previous last, its next, which was null earlier, will now carry the pointer of this newly created head, which is represented by this statement, next of last is equal to head. So in this way, what we have done, we have first checked if the node is a first one. If it is a first one, we have assigned first and last both names to this head. Otherwise, if it is not the first one, the last one in the list which was having null, now we have assigned the address of this newly created head so that it is attached with the list, and this head which is created being the last one is now assigned the name last. Then we have a display function which will display the data of the list as explained in the part 1. Without disturbing the name first, we have used another variable name p, which is equal to the first. So now the first has another name p, which will be used for traversing in the list. We are running a loop where the loop will run till p reaches to null, and till then it will read the value data of p, and then it will continue to move forward with the help of p is equal to next of the p. So initially the first one is p, then it will switch to the next one, because now p is next of the p. Next of the p means second node has become now p. Similarly, then third node will become p and its data will be read. So like this, it will read all the values of the list. Now coming down to the main function, here if we want to check our program, simply we will call the function create. It will create one node. After creating one node, then we can display the value of that node by calling the display function. So now I am going to run this program. So here we are. So you can see the program is asking one value. So let me enter some value, maybe 25. So you can see the display function has displayed the value 25. So once the functions are successfully working, now I can modify this program so that a user can keep on entering the values, and the program will keep on creating the nodes till the user says no. And finally, we will call a display function to display the elements of the list. So here is the modified main function, where I have taken two variables. One is to choose the option, one for the create mode and two for the display, as you can see in this printf state. And then since the program will be asking whether you want to do more, for that a user is supposed to enter yes or no. For that we have taken a character variable ch. So after clear screen, we are using do while loop. Now under do, what we are saying is to enter the option from the user. We are displaying the options and then we are telling user to choose the option, and that option is scanned under the variable option. So once a user gives the option, then we are switching over that option. So there may be two cases only, one to create the node and second one is to display. So in case one, we are calling the create function, which will create the node, and then we are doing a break statement. Similarly, in case two, we are calling the display function to display the elements of the list and then break. And if anyone presses any other option, then we have a default statement saying unknown choice. So this is a switch case. After this, we are asking user in the printf statement, do more activity, yes or no. If user presses yes, then it will further again display the choices, because it will start from do again. This program will continue till user presses no. So for this choice, we are scanning the character variable ch after doing fflush, and then we say that the do while loop will continue if user keeps on pressing yes. So here we run this program. So you can see it's asking two choices, one to create node and to display the list. So let us first enter the choice one. So I press one, so it will asking the data for the node. So my first data is 10, then it is asking to do more. Let us press yes, then again it displays the choices. So I again say yes to create a node. Now again it asks for the value, so let us press the value 20. Again asking more, let us say yes, and now we will display the elements. So I will say 2, and it should display now 10 and 20. So here we are, it's giving 10 and 20, you can see. Now still it is asking do more, so now I will say no. So this is all about the working of the program. So this is all about this program. Thanks for watching this video. We will see a full program of singly linked list using various functions like inserting nodes in the beginning, end, and at any location, then deleting nodes from beginning, end, or any location, counting the number of nodes, display the node element, etc. in the next video. That will be a final video, that is number 3 of singly linked list. Thanks again for watching this video.